By coincidence, the week that I started, our social purpose was adopted by the board. I find for me, especially working in ESG and sustainability, it gives me license to be innovative and think about how we can affect change at a provincial level and make enormous positive change across the province. My name is Jim Gudjonson. I'm the Manager of Sustainability Innovation here at BCLC. I've been developing our ESG framework, which is essentially a roadmap for how we can be more sustainable as an organization. Following us becoming a social purpose organization, the leadership decided we need to improve our efforts around ESG. ESG stands for Environment, Social, and Governance. And so what it does is give us precise metrics to measure our sustainability efforts. We designed the ESG framework to be not a plan, but a framework. So it could be embedded at a strategic level and at a divisional and departmental level as well. In the framework, under the E and the S and the G, there's three categories. So for example, under environment, we would have climate. We set a goal, and then we figure out exactly how we're going to achieve that goal. Under the S, for example, we have metrics around player health. Under the G, we have stakeholder accountability, Indigenous relations, so how do we actually improve our relationships with Indigenous communities and with the greater communities? When you think about doing a renovation, for example, the standard business as usual would be to look at, you know, making it less environmentally impactful. But when we're talking about integrating social purpose in and, you know, the full suite of ESG metrics into a renovation, then what we're talking about is creating a positive outcome. You're thinking about affecting change at a larger scale. And so those conversations are a bit different when you're a social purpose organization. In the past, perhaps in a major renovation, there might be a ribbon cutting, and you might invite the Indigenous community, hang a piece of art in the lobby, etc. But building relationships with the local band, Tecumloops, means inviting them in and getting their perspective right from the ground up. So how do we actually bring their values and their perspective into the design of the building? What attracted me to BCLC was the incredible opportunity that I saw to affect positive change across the province. It's very rewarding to think that we have, you know, top-down support right from the board, and we have this groundswell underneath us of excitement to actually roll up our sleeves and make some positive change.